Hey, folks, it's Lindsey Ellis with SPS back in the building at the DC Elite Summer League. Sitting here with the DC Elite Player of the Game. Just had my guy Christian Nichols, my guy from freshman to junior right now, and watched him grow up. Shout out to you, your family, my mother Tamika as well, with the De La Salle Pilots. And they just defeated Flint Beecher, that is the reigning state champions. Did you guys feel some kind of way going into this game?
We just felt like we had to come out playing hard, show what we got, show what we still got it from last year, even though we lost a couple players.
Yeah, and also, too, you were at the Breslin, too. I saw you guys getting out, sitting right behind you at that time. Shout out to your coach, Coach Joke, as well. With that being said, man, I can't help. This is a little bit more personal for me because I came over to speak to the male group, you know, your freshman year, and now here you are just dominating. You playing football, too, man.
Yes, sir.
So you got this championship mentality. You go to Ford Field, you go to the Breslin, like you had all the happening spots. What is it like as a student athlete to be sitting down as a player of the game, the focal point on football and basketball teams? You know, what has it been like for you?
It's been great. I've just been working hard, working every day, going to practice, showing up, and just being a leader of my team. And I feel like that plays a big part.
Yeah.
And going to the Breslin and going to Ford, that kind of like kind of helps me more. You know, we lost both games, so that kind of makes me next year want to win those games and go back.
Yeah, I want to put my sports psychology hat on. Talk about what the feeling was like preparing to go to play football at Ford Field to compete for a state championship, to play at the Breslin to compete for a state championship. And now that that experience has happened, how do you look at both sports now and look at the game now?
So how we prepare for that is, well, we had an inside gym because we knew it was going to be hot, so it was hot in there. So we kind of adapted to that condition. For basketball, the three-point lines, they're like different, so we knew that sometimes we're going to get messed up on where we were. So we shot from deep in practice, so that played a big part. And that carries along now, shooting from deep, shooting threes.
Mm-hmm. And so the preparation, huh?
Yes, sir.
Very important. Let's talk about just you being a young man. I'll speak to you being a young African-American male because you were part of the young African-American male program at De La Salle. Forget the exact name of it.
BSA.
BSA. And I got to come in and talk to you guys a couple of years ago, and I enjoyed that presentation as well. But just talk about, you know, what it's like being a young person who's an athlete in this age of social media where, you know, whether you're getting likes or not getting likes, you know, just what is it like just being a young person right now?
I mean, it's kind of hard, you know, seeing everyone, you know, like all the murders and stuff about black people. It's hard going on Instagram, scrolling, seeing that. And as of likes and stuff, I mean, that really doesn't matter. I mean, you still get looked at. You don't need all those likes. That doesn't make you anything.
Yeah, I get that. You know, you're a very humble young man, nice young man, nice temperament. I understand why by knowing your mom and your family and what you've been doing. You know, you got a great, great opportunity to do some great things in sports, man. I mean, not a lot of young people have it, where it's football or basketball. We all know what you love, you know what I'm saying? But size 15 shoe, any coach hear that? Like, he wears 15, he's a junior, nice size young man, smart young man. What's your GPA right now?
3.5,
you know, all those kind of things. What do you feel the opportunities can be like for you in the future?
I feel like I can make it big in either sport if I just try my hardest. And even if I don't, I can still do things in this sport and help out like other kids, and so they can have their dreams.
Yeah. There's no question you're going to have a great, great future. With the time that we have, anybody you want to shout out, anybody you want to just say what's up to, or just any last remarks you want to share?
Just wanted to shout out to Coach Yokai, basketball coach, and football coach, Coach Rome. Yes, sir.
That's it. Shouts out to his coaches. Great young man, Christian Nichols. You're going to hear some great things from him. Continue to support him. Shout out again to your family, your mom, and others who are doing great things. I want to wish you the best.
Sir.
All right, Christian?
Thank you.
All right. And he got a super firm handshake, too, to go along with that 3.5. All right. SPS is out. See you guys next time. Peace.
Hey, folks. It's Lindsey Huddleston with SPS. Thank you for watching the video, and also thank you for supporting our young people. I'm in a very unique position. I am a sports psychology consultant, but I also have media credentials, cover collegiate and high school sports. Just the past few seasons, I covered Michigan State football and basketball as an example. And one thing is true across the board for college level athletics, they do not, in most cases, prepare our young people to talk to the media. I'm probably the friendliest media person they'll come in contact with. So with that being said, I want to offer my service to you and to your young person as it relates to media training, not only to help them be successful talking to the media regarding their sports, but also in life. give them the confidence to communicate who they are and put a positive foot forward. So with that being said, you can reach me at the email below, lh@thespsedge.org. We are a nonprofit organization, so anything you do is not only going to support your young person, but other young people as well, as it relates to overcoming mental toughness and mental health in today's society. So with that, thank you for your support. Hopefully I can help your young person get the SPS Edge.